Hi everyone, I hope you all are doing well and welcome back to my channel Key Differences. I am Surbhi and today I am going to talk about the difference between horizontal integration and vertical integration. So friends, without further ado, let's dive right into our video. Strategic integration. There are different ways of organization's growth. Strategic integration is one such way for external growth of the organization. It refers to the step-by-step fusion and conversion of the specific section or operation of different units of a business organization into a single synergistic enterprise. Strategic integration can provide benefits including linking of core competencies, access to resources and technology, risk reduction, economies of scale, greater control over supplies, better access to customers, and reduced competition, which ultimately helps in improving the performance of the organization as well as increases its market share. It can be of two types, horizontal integration and vertical integration. Now we will discuss these two in detail. Horizontal integration. Horizontal integration is a business strategy in which one company acquires similar company that operates at the same level of the value chain. This integration results in access to new market and eliminates competition. It occurs when a firm enters into or acquires additional businesses which can be related or unrelated, operating at the same level of the production marketing chain. It can take place in two ways. When a firm enters into a new market by adding complementary products within its existing product range or by acquiring competing businesses. It is a competitive strategy which results in economies of scale, increased market power over distributors and suppliers, increased product differentiation, reduction in competition and increase in market share by expansion of the product lines with more varieties to cater the customer in different segments, types, affluence, etc. Vertical integration. In simple words, vertical integration is the competitive strategy whereby a firm internalizes those operations that are performed by the suppliers or distributors up or down the value chain. Such an integration results in greater control over the entire process of supply chain. It implies the integration of companies operating at different levels of the supply chain. That is, it is the acquisition of preceding or succeeding processes by the company. For example, suppose a company acquires the manufacturer or retail businesses. Then such an integration is called as vertical integration. It creates dominance of the company over the industry and increases self-sufficiency. In addition to this, it reduces the cost of production by eliminating markup at various levels and improves the operational efficiency of the concern. It can be of two types, forward or downstream integration, backward or upstream integration. Come, let's understand these two. Forward integration. Forward integration is the acquisition of the consumer company or distribution center by the firm to which it sells or provides its products or services. Backward integration. Backward integration occurs when a company takes control over its supplier or manufacturer of raw materials. So, in backward integration, the company enters into the business of input providers to get better supply and obtain greater dominance over production. Now we will discuss the differences between horizontal integration and vertical integration. Horizontal integration. Horizontal integration takes place when a company expands by acquiring a firm which is operating at the same level in the industry. On the other hand, vertical integration takes place when a company expands by acquiring another firm which operates above or below the firm in the supply chain. Next. The objective of horizontal integration is to take over competitors' business to create monopoly and geographically expand the business and get access to the competitors' customers. On the contrary, the objective of vertical integration is to strengthen the supply chain and increase dominance in the industry. Next, horizontal integration results in control over the market because it occurs when the firm takes over competitors' business, which creates monopoly and ultimately creates dominance over the entire market. Conversely, vertical integration leads to control over the industry in the sense that when the company acquires other firms operating at different levels of the supply chain, this creates dominance over the entire industry as the entire process is performed in-house by the firm. Next. Horizontal integration results in decrease in competition, increase in market share, and increase in revenue. Further, it helps in achieving economies of scale, whereas vertical integration results in reduction in the cost of transportation and inputs, and also reduces wastage of material and improves operational efficiency. Next, horizontal integration brings synergy. Synergy means the combined result of the two firms will be higher in comparison to the sum of their individual result. On the other hand, vertical integration brings self-sufficiency along with synergy. Self-sufficiency is gained by the firm when all the operations are performed internally. Last, in horizontal integration, the increase in profit is due to reduction in competition and economies of scale, whereas in vertical integration, increase in profit is due to the reduction in cost. So guys, this brings me to the end of this lesson. I hope the concepts have been cleared from today's lesson. However, if you want to study the topic further in detail, you can visit our official website, that is keydifferences.com. Here you can find a detailed comparison of horizontal and vertical integration along with their definition and examples. Links are also provided in the description box below. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please do give it a thumbs up. If you are new here, do subscribe to this channel and also hit the notification bell next to the subscribe button so that you are notified every time whenever a new video is uploaded. If you have any queries or feedback for me, then feel free to leave in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, this is me, Surbhi, signing off.